Welcome friends in another session of e-learning project. We discuss here the topic respiration. In a respiration, in earlier session we learned about glycolysis. In glycolysis, one glucose molecule split into the two molecules of the pyruvate or pyruvic acid. This pyruvic acid cannot enter directly into the Krebs cycle. So there is one change may occur in pyruvic acid. They undergo oxidative decarboxylation and converts into the acetyl-CoA. Now further oxidation of the acetyl-CoA occurs into the next step of aerobic respiration. This next step is called as Krebs cycle. Krebs cycle is a process through which acetyl coenzyme A completely oxidized and CO2 released in a stepwise manner. Means we know the acetyl coenzyme A is produced in a link reaction. This acetyl coenzyme A completely oxidized. During the complete oxidation of this acetyl coenzyme A, carbon dioxide is released in stepwise manner. Means here in Krebs cycle, two important events may occur. One is the complete oxidization of acetyl-CoA and second is the release of carbon dioxide. This process is a second stage of the aerobic respiration which occurs or takes place into the matrix of mitochondria. We know in the matrix of mitochondria so many enzymes are present. These enzymes are necessary for the steps or events which occurs inside the Krebs cycle. With the help of these enzymes, the complete breakdown of the acetyl coenzyme A takes place. So many enzymes, coenzymes are present in the mitochondria. During this stage, when the oxidation takes place, the coenzymes like the NAD, FAD may accept the hydrogen which is released during the oxidation of acetyl coenzyme A, and this coenzymes converts into the NADH2, FADH2. Such type of the important events may occur in the Krebs cycle. When this Krebs cycle occurs, in the Krebs cycle, at four times oxidation occur, and two times decarboxylation occurs. We know oxidation here is related with the removal of the hydrogen, and decarboxylation is related with the release of carbon dioxide. So in four steps, hydrogen is removed, this hydrogen is accepted by the NAD and FAD, and from them NADH2 and FADH2 are formed. And during the decarboxylation, carbon dioxide is released into the matrix, then gives outside of the mitochondria. So this process of a Krebs cycle is very important. How these total steps of the Krebs cycle are carried out, how these events may occur, which type of the enzyme may be used in this total process, are clearly described by the Sir Hans Krebs in 1937. So this pathway is called as a Krebs cycle. According to the Sir Hans Krebs, the first stable product formed in this process is citric acid, which is a 6-carbon compound. So here this total process is also called as the citric acid cycle. The citric acid is tricarboxylic acid. Three carboxylic groups are present. So citric acid cycle or Krebs cycle is also known as the TCA cycle. Means Krebs cycle is known by the various names like the citric acid cycle, tricarboxylic acid cycle, and also the TCA cycle. This research that how the various type of the products are formed, various type of the steps occur, have very important in the biochemistry, because this research, this study opened a new era in the cellular biochemistry. And therefore, Sir Hans Krebs was awarded by the Nobel Prize in biochemistry in 1953. So the work which is carried out by Sir Hans Krebs is very valuable. And how this total reactions takes place, how this process occur, we discuss here that which steps are occurs, how the changes may be that takes place. This total process we discuss in today's session. The first important in this Krebs cycle is the 4-oxidation occurs. During the oxidation, hydrogen is released. This hydrogen is accepted by the NAD. NAD converts into the NADH2, or sometime hydrogen is accepted by the FAD, and FAD converts into the FADH2. Also, in this Krebs cycle, carbon dioxide is released at two steps. And the important event is the regeneration of the oxaloacetic acid, which is the acceptor of the acetyl coenzyme A. Means when this process occurs, acetyl coenzyme A is accepted by the 4-carbon compound named as the oxaloacetic acid. In the oxaloacetic acid, there are so many changes occur. And at the end of this step, at the end of this process, oxaloacetic acid is again regenerated to continue the Krebs cycle. So, such type of the important events may occur into the Krebs cycle. So, now we discuss in briefly the Krebs cycle. In Krebs cycle, the glucose molecule by the process of glycolysis converts into the two molecules of the pyruvate. These two molecules of the pyruvate in link reaction converts into the two molecules of the acetyl coenzyme A. This acetyl coenzyme A may get combined or we say get condensed with a four carbon compound. This four carbon compound is the oxaloacetic acid. This is four carbon compound. As a result of this condensation of the acetyl coenzyme A, which is a two carbon compound, and oxaloacetic acid, which is a four carbon compound, here six carbon compound known as the citrate or citric acid is formed. The citrate which is formed here, or a citric acid which is formed here, is the stable compound, and therefore this Krebs cycle is known as the citric acid cycle. This total process is catalyzed with the help of enzyme citrate synthetase. Means this condensation of acetyl coenzyme A and oxaloacetic acid is catalyzed by the help of enzyme citrate synthetase. During this process, one water molecule is also utilized. When this citrate undergo various changes, here acetyl coenzyme A is removed from this citrate, and this acetyl coenzyme A is used for the process of the again continuation of this Krebs cycle. So from this citrate, the coenzyme A may get released. So the regeneration of the total process or the oxaloacetic acid occurs, and a fresh molecule of the acid coenzyme A enters in the Krebs cycle, and Krebs cycle remains continuously ongoing. In this way, this Krebs cycle may be the occur. The first step in the Krebs cycle is of the condensation of the oxaloacetic acid with acetyl coenzyme A, in which the citrate is formed. This citrate or citric acid is first stable compound, so it is called as the citric acid cycle. Citric acid cycle now undergo the isomerization. Means citric acid forms its isomer named as isocitrate. But when this citrate undergo isomerization, here the two step may be the occur. In one step, dehydration occurs. Dehydration occurs means from the citrate molecule, water molecule may get removed. And due to this, the citrate or a citric acid may get convert into the cis aconitate. Cis aconitate. Again, this cis aconitate forms the isomer of citrate, termed as the isocitrate. During this, again, it takes one water molecule and forms the isocitrate. Means, during the isomerization of citrate to isocitrate, this isomerization does not occur directly. First, citrate undergo dehydration and forms the cis aconitate. Again, cis aconitate combines with the water molecule, means process of the hydration occurs, and here the isocitrate is formed. This is the isomer of citrate. This total process is catalyzed by the enzyme aconitase and iron molecules. Aconitase आणि Fe plus plus ions या मार्फत ही जी प्रोसेस आहे ही प्रोसेस कॅटलाइज केली जाते. देन आयसोसायट्रेट अंडरगो द ऑक्सिडेशन. ऑक्सिडेशन मीन्स फ्रॉम द आयसोसायट्रेट व्हिच इज अ सिक्स कार्बन कंपाउंड, हेअर वन हायड्रोजन मॉलिक्यूल इज रिलीज्ड. दिस two hydrogen atom or one hydrogen molecule may get combined with the NAD to form the NADH2. And as the isocitrate lose the two hydrogen atoms, this isocitrate may get convert into the oxalosuccinate or oxalosuccinic acid. Oxalosuccinate or the oxalosuccinic acid. Here the oxidation occurs. Here we say this is the first oxidation or the dehydrogenation one. Ha oxidation cha step madhe hydrogen nigun janar hai, म्हणून आपण त्या स्टेपला डिहायड्रोजनेशन असं म्हणतो. आणि क्रेब सायकलमध्ये पहिल्याच वेळेस हायड्रोजन निघून गेलेला आहे म्हणून त्याला आपण डिहायड्रोजनेशन वन असं सुद्धा म्हणतो. दिस प्रोसेस इज कॅटलाइज्ड बाय द एन्झाइम आयसोसायट्रेट डिहायड्रोजनेज अँड एम एन प्लस प्लस आयन्स. मीन्स हेअर the various enzymes are necessary, and to carry out this process only the enzymes are present in the matrix of the mitochondria. So Krebs cycle, or may the we can say shortly, respiration occurs only and only inside the process, and therefore in the definition of the respiration we say respiration is the intracellular process, because all the enzymes to carry out such changes are present only and only inside the cytoplasm and mitochondria. So here the from isocitrate, due to the oxidation or removal of the two hydrogen atoms, oxalosuccinate is formed. Then oxalosuccinate undergoes the decarboxylation in the presence of decarboxylase enzyme, and alpha ketoglutarate is formed. This stage is called as the decarboxylation. Why called decarboxylation? Because from oxalosuccinate, which is a six carbon compound, here carbon dioxide is released, and therefore this alpha ketoglutarate becomes the 5-carbon compound. Means now the one carbon dioxide may get removed from the oxalosuccinate, and this process is generally termed as the decarboxylation. The removal of the carbon dioxide is known as the decarboxylation. This is the first step in which the carbon dioxide is released. Then the very important event takes place in the Krebs cycle, that the alpha ketoglutarate or alpha ketoglutaric acid, which is a 5-carbon compound, undergo oxidative decarboxylation. Oxidative decarboxylation means here the oxidation occur. First we say oxidation occur. This oxidation is related with the dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation means the removal of hydrogen, and this dehydrogenation occurs at the second time, though this is the second dehydrogenation step. And this hydrogen which are released are accepted by NAD, and this NAD may get converted into the NADH2. Why such type of the changes may the take place? Because the hydrogen released from the alpha ketoglutarate is accepted or taken by the NAD, and therefore NAD may convert into the NADH2. At the same time, when the oxidation or the dehydrogenation occurs, decarboxylation also occurs. Decarboxylation occurs means here we can say carbon dioxide is released. First also decarboxylation occurs, here the second step where the decarboxylation occurs. Therefore we say decarboxylation second means here the carbon dioxide released. Means this process occurs at a stepwise manner. Carbon dioxide released from the this acetyl coenzyme A, 2 carbon dioxides are released. Now the alpha ketoglutarate, which is a 5-carbon compound, now becomes the 4-carbon compound. The name of this 4-carbon compound is the succinyl coenzyme A. So the succinyl coenzyme A, which is a 4-carbon compound, may take place here. In this way, here this process of the Krebs cycle may occur, in which the acetyl coenzyme A enters with the oxaloacetic acid, and the changes may be the takes place. During the changes, sometime hydrogen is released and accepted by the NAD. NAD converted into the NADH2. Also the decarboxylation takes place. This carbon dioxide which is released may get goes outside of the matrix, and therefore this process occurs continuously. Then the next process or the next step during this Krebs cycle is the hydration and phosphorylation. This hydration and phosphorylation is a very important step. Why important? Hydration means here the water molecule combines with the succinyl coenzyme A. As here the water molecule form here combines with the succinyl coenzyme A, the coenzyme A is removed from the succinyl coenzyme A, and therefore succinyl coenzyme A gets converted into the succinate or succinic acid. This is also the 4-carbon compound. Means here we can say the succinyl coenzyme A, which is a 4-carbon compound, combines with the water. Water plays here important role in the separation of the succinate and a coenzyme A. This succinate here formed as a 4-carbon compound, and coenzyme A may remains in the matrix to carry out the further process. So these steps which occurs here are very simultaneously occurs, and when here the succinate is formed, again phosphorylation occurs. Phosphorylation occurs means here from the succinyl coenzyme A, one phosphate may get removed. This phosphate removed may be accepted by the GDP, and therefore this GDP may get converts into the GTP. GDP is the guanine diphosphate. When phosphorylation occurs, this phosphorylated oxygen phosphate combines with the GDP and forms the GTP. GTP, which is formed here, is not the constant, and therefore this GTP again loses the phosphate, and this phosphate combines with the ADP, and therefore here the ATP molecule is formed. Here ATP molecule is not directly formed, that the ADP and phosphorylated phosphate combines with the ADP and forms the ATP. Such type of the process does not take place. Or also the ATP is not formed by the entering into the electron transfer system, that the electron transfer system energy is released, and due to this the ADP and inorganic phosphate may get come together and ATP is formed. So such process here does not take place, and therefore we can say such type of the formation of the ATP without entering in the ETS is the substrate level phosphorylation. Substrate level phosphorylation, this formation of the ATP is termed. And therefore, in the this step from the succinyl coenzyme A, two events may occur. One, the hydration takes place. Due to this, the coenzyme A released, and the also from succinyl coenzyme A, phosphate get removed. So the phosphorylation takes place, and as a result of phosphorylation, ATP is formed. ATP is not formed directly, but first this phosphate goes towards the GDP. GDP forms the GTP. GTP combines with the ADP, and this ADP accepts the phosphate from the GTP and then forms the ATP. So such type of the formation of the ATP without entering into the ETS is called as the substrate level phosphorylation. Now in the next step, that the oxidation. Oxidation. This oxidation occurs by the removal of hydrogen. By the removal of hydrogen means dehydrogenation. And this dehydrogenation occurs now at the third time. And so this is known as the dehydrogenation third. When hydrogen is released, this hydrogen now is not accepted by the NAD. Hydrogen is accepted here by the FAD, and therefore this FAD may get converted into the FADH2. This hydrogen combines with the FAD and forms the FADH2. So in this way, here the oxidation occurs, and from the succinate, fumarate or fumaric acid is formed. This formation of the fumarate or this oxidation of the succinate occurs in the presence of the enzyme, the succinate dehydrogenase. Succinate dehydrogenase is enzyme which catalyzes the oxidation or dehydrogenation of the succinate and converts the succinate into the fumarate. So in this way, this steps and the oxidation occurs by the stepwise manner. So the respiration is a stepwise process, stepwise release of the energy, formation of the NADH2, release of the carbon dioxide occurs. And now fumarate undergo the hydration. Means fumarate combines with the water molecule in the presence of enzyme fumarase and forms the substance which is also the four carbon substance called as the malate or the malic acid. And this malic acid or a malate now undergo the oxidation in presence of the enzyme malate dehydrogenase. Means here also the oxidation occurs. During the oxidation we know that here the hydrogen is released, so this step or this stage is called as the dehydrogenation. This dehydrogenation or oxidation now occurs at the fourth time, first, second, third and fourth. So this dehydrogenation is termed as dehydrogenation 4. And here the hydrogen which is released or removed from this process is accepted by the NAD, and this NAD converts into the NADH2. Means here, due to the oxidation of the malate, here the again new substance is formed. New substance is the oxaloacetic acid. Means in the Krebs cycle, the regeneration of the first substance which is involved in the process or accepts the acetyl coenzyme A takes place. So in this event, continuously oxaloacetic acid is formed and continuously coenzyme A are released into the matrix, and this process may going on. Why process may be going on? Because glucose breakdown into the pyruvate continuously by the process of glycolysis. Then pyruvate, two molecules of the pyruvate are formed. When two pyruvates get converted into the two molecules of the acetyl coenzyme A, at one time only one molecule of the acetyl coenzyme A enters into the Krebs cycle, and as they enters into the Krebs cycle, they regenerate the oxaloacetic acid, which is necessary for the second complete oxidation of the another acetyl coenzyme A molecule. And therefore here the three important events may occur into the Krebs cycle, that at the four times the oxidation occur, 1, 2, 3, 4, two times decarboxylation takes place, and third is the regeneration of the oxaloacetic acid, which is the acceptor of the acetyl coenzyme A. So in this way the process of the Krebs cycle may occurs. Krebs cycle process is important. Why important? Because during this process, so many enzymes are formed, so many products are formed, and these products which are formed as a byproduct of this Krebs cycle may utilized in the another some cellular or metabolic activities of the living organisms. And so the research of this Krebs cycle, or research how the acetyl coenzyme A may get completely oxidized inside the Krebs cycle, opens the new era and in the biochemistry. Therefore the Sir Hans Krebs may awarded by the Nobel Prize. In this way we say the Krebs cycle is the very important process, or somewhat we say the compulsory events in the aerobic respiration of the living organisms, in which the complete oxidization of the food molecule or complex food molecules takes place, and different type of the NADH2 molecules are formed, carbon dioxide released. So this Krebs cycle have somewhat more importance. Glucose molecule glycolysis process dware split hoto, ha don pyruvate molecules madhe split hoto. He don पायरुवेटचे मॉलिक्यूल क्रेब सायकलमध्ये डायरेक्ट एंट्री करत नाहीत, म्हणून त्यांचं रूपांतर लिंक रिॲक्शननं ॲसिटिल को एन्झाईम एमध्ये होतं, इथपर्यंतची माहिती घेतली होती. आज आपण क्रेब सायकलबद्दल माहिती घेतो आहोत. क्रेब सायकल ही एक अत्यंत महत्त्वाची असलेली एरोबिक रिस्पायरेशनची स्टेप आहे, इन विच ॲसिटिल को एन्झाईम ए is completely oxidized and carbon dioxide is released in a stepwise manner. Acetyl coenzyme A madhe ji energy store hai, ती सर्व एनर्जी ऑक्सिडेशनच्या स्वरूपामध्ये पूर्णपणे बाहेर काढण्याचं काम ह्या क्रेब सायकलमध्ये केलं जातं. कशा पद्धतीनं केलं जातं? तर इथे असलेला हा ॲसिटिल को एन्झाईम ए गेट्स कंडेन्स्ड विथ ऑक्झॅलो ॲसिटिक ॲसिड अँड फॉर्म्स अ सायट्रेट. सायट्रेट इज अ 6-carbon कंपाऊंड विच इज अ स्टेबल कंपाऊंड. देअरफोर द क्रेब सायकल इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज द सायट्रिक ॲसिड सायकल. नाऊ दिस सायट्रेट may get convert into its isomer, that is the isocitrate. But this process does not take directly. First, dehydration occurs. Manje citrate molecule pasun ek water molecule bahar padto. Manun citrate cha rupantar cis aconitate madhe hota. Hya itha citrate cha rupantar cis aconitate madhe ghadna. आणि परत सिस ॲकोनिटेटचं हायड्रेशन घडणं म्हणजे परत सिस ॲकोनिटेट वॉटर मॉलिक्युलबरोबर कंबाईन होतो आणि मग आयसोसायट्रेट तयार करतो. ही जी प्रोसेस आहे ही प्रोसेस एन्झाईम ॲकोनिटेजमार्फत पार पाडली जाते. मीन्स द सायट्रेट कन्वर्ट्स इन टू आयसोसायट्रेट बाय द डिहायड्रेशन अँड हायड्रेशन विच इज कॅटलाइज्ड बाय द एन्झाईम ॲकोनिटेज. देन the oxidation takes place. Oxidation of isocitrate takes place. Here oxidation means the removal of hydrogens. So this term is also known as the dehydrogenation. This process of oxidation is catalyzed by the enzyme isocitrate dehydrogenase. And this removed hydrogen is accepted by NAD, which converts into the NADH2. And oxalosuccinate is formed. Now, oxalosuccinate undergoes the decarboxylation with the help of enzyme decarboxylase. Decarboxylase enzyme cha sahayana oxalosuccinate cha decarboxylation hota. आणि हे डिकार्बोक्झिलेशन झाल्यानंतर ऑक्झॅलोसक्सिनेटचं रूपांतर अल्फा किटो ग्लुटारेटमध्ये होतं. ऑक्झॅलोसक्सिनेट हा 6-carbon कंपाऊंड आहे. 1 carbon डायऑक्साईड निघून गेल्यामुळे अल्फा किटो ग्लुटारेट हा 5-carbon कंपाऊंड इथे तयार होतो. दिस 5-carbon कंपाऊंड अल्फा किटो ग्लुटारेट नाव अंडरगोज ऑक्सिडेटिव्ह डिकार्बोक्झिलेशन. Oxidative decarboxylation is somewhat similar with the link reaction. म्हणजे ज्यावेळेस पायरुवेटचं रूपांतर ॲसिटिल को एन्झाईम एमध्ये होत आहे त्यावेळेस पण ऑक्सिडेटिव्ह डिकार्बोक्झिलेशन होत आहे. अगदी तशाच प्रकारची ही प्रक्रिया आहे. अल्फा किटो ग्लुटारेट कंबाईन्स विथ द को एन्झाईम ए. देअरफोर अल्फा किटो ग्लुटारेट मे कन्वर्ट्स इन टू द सक्सिनिल को एन्झाईम ए. बट during these stages carbon dioxide released, so decarboxylation occurs and this released carbon dioxide go outside the mitochondria, then oxidation occur. Oxidation is in the terms of the dehydrogenation. Hydrogen is released and this hydrogen is accepted by the NAD and converts into the NADH2. This process takes place with the help of alpha keto glutarate dehydrogenase enzyme. Atishay sadhya sopya paddhatina ha itha hi prakriya ghadte. Ani mag ha itha aslela alpha keto glutarate jo coenzyme A barobar convert zala tyacha rupantar succinyl coenzyme A madhe hota. Carbon dioxide nighun gelyamule ata succinyl coenzyme A jo ahe ha 4-carbon compound rahto. This succinyl coenzyme A now undergoes the hydration and a phosphorylation. Hydration means succinyl coenzyme A combines with the water. When succinyl coenzyme A combines with the water, coenzyme A may get removed from the succinyl and therefore it may get converts into the succinate. Also from the succinyl coenzyme A one phosphate molecule may get removed. This phosphate molecule combines here with the GDP, guanine diphosphate. And this GDP converts into the GTP. This GTP is not a stable, this is an unstable compound. So the GTP again combines with the ADP and loses one phosphate molecule. This ADP now converts into the ATP. ह्या इथं आपण अगोदर पाहिलं की ADP आणि इनऑर्गॅनिक फॉस्फेट डायरेक्ट एकत्र येतात आणि ATP तयार करतात, परंतु इथं तसं घडत नाही. इथं फॉस्फेट हा GDP-कडे जातो, त्याचं रूपांतर GTP-मध्ये होतं, GTP पुन्हा त्याच्याकडचा फॉस्फेट लूज करतो आणि तो ॲक्सेप्ट ADP करतो आणि मग त्याचं रूपांतर ATP-मध्ये होतं. तसंच ह्या इथं ATP तयार होत असताना डायरेक्ट आपल्याला सांगता येईल की तो इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रान्सपोर्ट सिस्टममध्ये एंट्री करत नाही, तरी पण ATP तयार होत आहे. आणि म्हणून ही जी ATP तयार होण्याची प्रक्रिया आहे त्याला आपण सबस्ट्रेट लेव्हल फॉस्फोरिलेशन म्हणतो. म्हणजे इथलचं जे फॉस्फोरिलेशन आहे ते सबस्ट्रेट लेव्हल फॉस्फोरिलेशन आहे. आणि मग हा तयार झालेला जो 4-कार्बन कंपाऊंड आहे सक्सिनेट, दिस सक्सिनेट अगेन अंडरगोज द ऑक्सिडेशन. ऑक्सिडेशन इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ द डिहायड्रोजनेशन. सो द टू ॲटम्स ऑफ द हायड्रोजन्स विच आर रिलीज्ड फ्रॉम सक्सिनेट हेअर ॲक्सेप्टेड बाय द FAD, नॉट बाय द NAD. अँड दिस FAD कन्वर्स इन टू द FADH2, सक्सिनेट कन्वर्स इन टू द फ्युमॅरेट. दिस कन्व्हर्जन ऑफ द सक्सिनेट इन टू द फ्युमॅरेट ऑर द प्रोसेस ऑफ द ऑक्सिडेशन इज कॅटलाइज्ड बाय द एन्झाईम सक्सिनेट डी हायड्रोजनेट्स. देन फ्युमॅरेट अंडरगोज द हायड्रेशन, means combines with the water molecule. As a result, fumarate forms the malate or malic acid, which is also the 4-carbon compound, which is catalyzed by the enzyme fumarase. And mag has a malate. Malate again undergoes the oxidation in terms of the dehydrogenation. Two atoms released by the hydrogen are accepted by the NAD, and NAD converts into the NADH2. आणि ह्या मॅलेटपासून सुरुवातीला ह्या प्रोसेसमध्ये जिथं ऑक्झालोॲसिटिक ॲसिडनं कंडेन्सेशन झालं होतं तोच प्रोडक्ट इथे पुन्हा तयार होतो आहे. रिजनरेशन ऑफ द ऑक्झालोॲसिटिक ॲसिड टेक्स प्लेस बाय द मॅलेट. दिस प्रोसेस इज कॅटलाइज्ड बाय द मॅलेट डी हायड्रोजनेज. आणि मग जो एक ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइम एच्या क्रेब सायकलच्या रिॲक्शन्स होत्या अगदी त्याच पद्धतीनं दुसरा ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइम एचा मॉलिक्यूल ह्या क्रेब सायकलमध्ये ऑक्झॅलो ॲसिटिक ॲसिडद्वारेच तिथे एंट्री करतो आणि ती प्रोसेस कंटिन्युअसली चालू राहते आणि कंटिन्युअसली सेलमध्ये ATP टप्प्याटप्प्यानं स्टेप वाईज मॅनर तयार होतात. आता तुमच्या मनामध्ये असा प्रश्न पडेल की निश्चितच ह्या इथं जो काही समजा ATP तयार झालेला आहे, सर ग्लायकोलिसिसमध्ये 2 ATP तयार झाले आमच्या लक्षात आलं, ह्या इथे तर एकच ATP तयार झाला आहे. बरोबर आहे. एका मॉलिक्यूलचं ज्यावेळेस कम्प्लीट ऑक्सिडेशन होईल ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइमचं त्यावेळेस 1 ATP. 2 ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइम एका ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्यूलपासून होतात, म्हणून एका ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्यूलचं कम्प्लीट ऑक्सिडेशन होत असताना क्रेब सायकलमध्ये 2 ATP तयार होतील. त्यांच्यासोबत 3 NADH2 तयार झालेले आहेत एका ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइमचं ब्रेकडाऊन होत असताना. म्हणून 2 ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइमचं ब्रेकडाऊन होत असताना 6 NADH2 तयार होतील. आणि एका ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइम याचं ब्रेकडाऊन होत असताना 1 FADH2, 2 ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइम हे ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्युलपासून तयार झाले आहेत, म्हणून 2 FADH2 क्रेब सायकलमध्ये तयार होतील. आणि कार्बन डायऑक्साईड इथे 2 मॉलिक्यूल बाहेर पडलेत. ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्यूल C6H12O6 म्हणजे 6 कार्बन डायऑक्साईड इथून बाहेर पडायला पाहिजेत, कारण ते फोटोसिंथेसिसच्या प्रोसेसमध्ये 6 कार्बन डायऑक्साईड 1 ग्लुकोजचं तयार होण्यासाठी आवश्यक आहेत. मग इथं तर तुम्ही म्हणताल 2च आहेत, एका ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइमपासून 2 आहेत, 2 ॲसिटिल कोएन्झाइमपासून 4 आणि लिंक रिॲक्शनमध्ये तयार झालेले रिलीज झालेले 2, असे एकूण 6 कार्बन डायऑक्साईड परत ॲटमॉस्फिअरमध्ये एका ग्लुकोजचं ब्रेकडाऊन झाल्यानंतर बाहेर सोडले जातात. आणि म्हणून ह्या इथे आपल्याला सांगता येईल की आता ग्लुकोज खरोखर कम्प्लीट ब्रेकडाऊन झाला. C6H12O6 होता 6 कार्बन डायऑक्साईड, तयार झाले, रिलीज झाले, बाहेर गेले. आणि एका ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्यूलचं ब्रेकडाऊन होत असताना ग्लायकोलिसिसच्या तिथे काही NADH2 आणि ATP मॉलिक्यूल्स तयार झाले. लिंक रिॲक्शनमध्ये काही NADH2 तयार झाले आणि क्रेब सायकलमध्ये 6 NADH2, 2 FADH2 आणि 2 ATP मॉलिक्यूल्स तयार झाले. मग आता पुन्हा तुमच्या मनामध्ये प्रश्न पडेल की सर तुम्ही तर सुरुवातीला म्हटलात कम्प्लीट ऑक्सिडेशन, पूर्णपणे ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्यूल ब्रेकडाऊन होईल आणि 38 ATP तयार होतील, 38 ATP आर फॉर्म इन द कम्प्लीट ऑक्सिडेशन ऑफ द सिंगल ग्लुकोज मॉलिक्यूल ऑकर्स. इथं तर 4 ATP तयार झालेत. हो, 4 ATP तयार झालेत. आता शिल्लक राहिलेले जे 34 ATP आहेत, हे 34 ATP कशा पद्धतीनं आणि कोणत्या प्रोसेसनं तयार होणार आहेत हे आपण नंतरचा सेशन, की जी प्रक्रिया आहे इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रान्सफर सिस्टीम, ज्या इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रान्सफर सिस्टममध्ये NADH2 पासून ATP तयार होतात, हे कशा पद्धतीनं घडतं आणि हे नेमकं इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रान्सफर सिस्टम काय आहे याबद्दलची माहिती आपण नंतरच्या सेशनमध्ये घेणार आहोत. ओके, थँक्यू.